All right, we've talked about parametric equations and how they trace out a curve and space curves. Well, this is, we're talking about a parametric surface. It's a surface described by a vector function R of u and v, where the I component is the function x of u and v, the j component is the function y of u and v, and the k component is the function of u and v. It's defined on a region D in the UV plane. And as U and V vary, the X, Y, and Z give you sets of ordered triples that when you plot them, plot a surface in three dimensions. Okay, and there's no way I can do it by hand. But one of the main reasons that I think that they use parametric surfaces instead of just trying to graph a surface is that you can get a more accurate graph by using a parametric equation than you can by using a scalar function. We're all writing down, so I was going to see if I could show it to you on my computer, my calculator. Okay, I'm assuming you've got that written. All right. A vector function, I'm going to show you how to write a parametric vector function for a plane that goes through a point, P sub 0, that has a position vector of R sub 0, and the plane contains two non-parallel vectors, A and B. Then the vector equation of the plane is this equation right here, where R sub 0 is your position vector. The A and the B are non-parallel vectors. Then this is your vector equation for a plane, which gives you these parametric equations, and I will show you an example. Yeah, read that. Have you got it? This is A1, A2, A3. This is B1, B2, and B3. This is just the components of the A and B vectors. And then down here, this is A1, A2, A3. This is B1, B2, and B3. Be like dead time on this lecture thing. Gotta have to fast forward through this. Okay, Devin, you're about there? Okay, or you can pause the video. Okay, as I was saying, one of the main reasons that I can think of that you would want to plot a function in terms of a parametric equation as opposed to solving an equation for z, this is two different graphs of x squared plus y squared plus z squared is equal to 1. This one is graphed by a computer. Both of them are graphed by computers, obviously. This one, they solved the equation for z and got a plus square root and a minus square root and plotted it. And you see it when it put the two square roots together, it left you holes because it couldn't quite get everything. This is the same graph, but they chose to write it as a parametric function instead. And you'll notice that it fills in the gaps. It's able to get more accurate graph. So this is one reason for using parametric equations for a surface. Okay. All right, now, before we get to a few of these parametric equations, first of all, the first kind of problem you're going to have to do is a problem like number one, where they give you a vector function, u and v, and it's u plus v, u minus 2v, and 3 plus u minus v. They give you the vector function, and they give you point 4, negative 5, 1, and then they give you point q, which is 0, 4, 6. And they simply ask you, is point p on that surface, and is point q on that surface? All right, so it's a simple question. It's a yes or no question. But the way you tell is you have to set up a system of equations. Two separate questions. Is p on this surface? Well, if it is, then you've got to be able to set up these equations so that you can find the u and the v that work for everything. So you'd set up u plus v is equal to 4, u minus 2v is equal to negative 5, and u plus v is equal to 1. No, no, no. Where am I doing that? 3 plus u, how about that? 3 plus u minus v has got to equal to 1. So you've got these three equations. You've got to be able to find your u and v. I guess y'all want me to go ahead and do it? Yes, okay. Let's see what I guess I would solve this one for u. U is 4 minus v. So if I put it in here, 4 minus v, minus 2v is negative 5. Negative 3v is negative 9. It looks like v is 3. If v is 3, u must be 1. So then I need to take these two and put it over here. 3 plus 1 minus 3, is that equal to 1? And it is. I got 1 is equal to 1. So I can get a u and a v. Therefore, p is on the surface that's traced out by that vector function. And then you would do the same thing for q. Okay? Are we good with that? Okay. Just is the point on the surface. All right, the next thing I want you to do a few of is to find a parametric representation for a surface. Number 20 says find a parametric representation for the plane that passes through the point 0, negative 1, 5, and it contains the vectors 2, 1, 4, and the vector negative 3, 2, and 5. All right, so this is parametric representation for a plane. I gave you that formula at the bottom of that page. That's what everybody's so copying so quickly. All right, this is your p sub 0 right here. These are your two vectors. You just need to make sure these are not parallel vectors. How do you know that they're not parallel? They're not multiples of each other. As long as they are not multiples of each other, you can use these two vectors and this point. This can be your vector A. This can be your vector B. So the parametric representation would be that x is this point, 0, plus 2 times u minus 3 times v. Over here, minus 3 times v. Your y is negative 1 plus u plus 2v. And your z would be 5 plus 4u plus 5v. And how do they want this answer written? Just like that. X equals something, y is equal to something, z is equal to something. That's it.
Okay.
For this one. Okay. Number 22 is a little bit different. It says find the parametric representation for the part of the ellipsoid x squared plus 2y squared plus 3z squared equals to 1 that lies to the left of the xz plane. Okay, something I forgot to say or failed to mention is that parametric representation is not unique. There are an infinite number of parametric representations for the same curve. You got to find one. Probably on WebAssign, they're pretty restrictive on what you got to find, too, is what I'm thinking. But I'm going to just show you what I would do for this. All right, first of all, this is an ellipsoid. If it's to the left of the xz plane, let's just look at this for a second. This is x, this is y, this is z. This is the xz plane right here. If it's to the left of the xz plane, then it's over here, and it's ellipsoid that's going to be over here, okay? The only thing that you really know about this is that the y values will not be positive because it's on the left side of that xz plane, so it's over there where your y values are negative. So I would solve this for y and look at the negative square root. That's how I would start. So solving this for y, 2y squared is 1 minus x squared minus 3z squared. Y squared is what? 1 half minus 1 half x squared minus 3 halves, z squared. Take the square root, and I want the negative square root because I'm on the left of that plane. The negative square root of 1 half minus 1 half x squared minus 3 halves z squared. Now, it is not absolutely necessary that you write everything in terms of u's and v's. You can use x's and y's and z's, but I have a feeling that on WebAssign, and let me look to be sure, they want u's and v's. So I'm going to change everything to u's and v's. So what I would do, since I solved this for y, I would let, so x could be u. You could let z be v, and then y would be the negative square root of 1 half minus 1 half u squared minus 3 half v squared. Okay, so these would be your parametric equations. Again, this is not unique, but this does it, okay? A question about what I'm going to ask you to do about these. And that's it. I'm done. Okay, find a parametric representation for your surface. Okay. Now, we've got these parametric surfaces. We might need to find the equation of a tangent plane to the surface. All right, do you remember how to find, now this is not asking for a parametric representation of the tangent plane, it's asking for a scalar function. Do you remember what you need for the equation of a plane? Just a regular plane, not a. You need a normal vector to get your direction, and you have to have a point. So your equation, the equation that you're trying to get with A, B, and C being your direction vectors is A, X minus X zero, B, Y minus Y zero, C is Z minus Z sub zero equals to zero. Oops, you dropped everything. All right, that's the equation of a plane. All right, and A, B, and C are your direction, from your direction vectors. Well, if this is your parametric surface, to get your direction vector, you take the partial with respect to U, take the partial with respect to V, do the cross product. That gives you a normal vector to get you your ABC. So do cross product to get your direction vector, which is going to be vector ABC. And you will have a point, or you can find a point with the given information. I'm not doing surface area right now, but you can go ahead and write down the surface area. We're also going to find the surface area of these things, these parametric surfaces, and these are the two formulas for surface area of one of these. This is if you have a vector function, this is if you have the normal function. Then I'm going to look at number 34. All right, in number 30, is everybody ready for 34? Not quite. Okay. I'm going to be looking for the equation of the tangent plane, is what I'm going to be looking for. All right, number 34, they give me x is u squared plus 1, y is b to the third plus 1, and z is u plus v, and I want the equation of the tangent plane at the point 5, 2, 3. So, when they give you the x, y's, and z's, this is nothing more than the parametric equations for your vector function. All right, you need your direction vector, so you need r with respect to u, which is 2u, 0, 1. You need R with respect to V, which is 0, 3V squared, and 1. And you need the cross product, so 2U, 0, 1, 0, 3V squared, 1. All right, this is I, 0 minus 3v squared, minus j, that's 2u, plus k, which is 6uv squared. So this gives me the vector negative 3v squared, negative 2u, and 6uv squared. This is my direction vector. Are y'all with me? In order to get these components, I need to know what U and V are. But all they gave me is this point, and this is an X, Y, and a Z. So you're going to have to go back and find out what U and V are in order to get these numbers. Okay? So set up your equations to find U and V. So 5 is U squared plus 1 if I subtract. 4 is U squared. So U is either positive or negative 2. Don't forget to look at both of them. All right, V. All right, 2 is V to the third plus 1 if I subtract 1. The cube root of 1 is 1. So V is 1. There is no positive and negative here. And then if I go to my third equation where I know U plus V has got to be equal to 3, and I know V is 1, all right, then U's got to be 2. It's got to be the positive 2. So U is positive 2, V is positive 1. I can get my direction vectors. Negative 3, negative 4, and 12. All right, so the equation of the plane then is negative 3 times x minus 5 minus 4 times y minus 2 plus 12 times z minus 3 equals to 0. Okay, y'all with me? And then you probably want to distribute that and simplify a little bit. No, you don't want to? That's what I figured. But you could probably do it. If push came to shove, you could probably simplify that a little bit. But this is what they are looking for. The equation of the tangent plane. Get your direction vectors and your point. A question about that? Okay, did y'all write down your equation for surface area? Because the next problem I was going to look at was going to be surface area. Everybody get these? All right. You use this one if your function is given in vector form. You can use this one if your function is given in just a regular scalar function. We've used this formula before, actually, for the surface area, if I'm not mistaken. We probably have not used this form. So let me look at one of these. Maybe number 40, perhaps. Number 40 says find the area of the surface, so area of the surface, the part of the plane with the vector equation R of U and V is U plus V. 2 minus 3u. Oops, forgot the other component. 1 plus u minus v. And the u and v, u goes from 0 to 2, and v just goes from negative 1 to positive 1. So you would use this top equation right here to find the surface area. So again, you need the partial with respect to u, which is 1, negative 3, 1. The partial with respect to v, which is 1, 0, negative 1. You need their cross product. One, negative three, one, one, zero, negative one. So three minus j, negative one, minus one, plus k, 0 minus a negative 3 makes that a positive 3. So this gives me the vector 3, positive 2, 3. Then I just need the magnitude of that. So the magnitude of this is the square root of 9 plus 4 plus 9. What's the second, maybe the square root of 22? So I need the double integral of the square root of 22 dA. They gave me my limits of integration. So I'm integrating from 0 to 2 with my respect to u. I'm integrating from negative 1 to 1 with respect to v. So this is dv du. And that's how you find the surface area. Do I need to do another one in terms of x, y's, and z's? Let you look at that. And I'm assuming again that we can integrate that. Say yes to this one, okay? Okay. Do I need to do another one? Don't let him speak for everybody. I can handle the slow at writing if you're understanding what we're doing here.
I think
it's part of the line, so
I'm
second
guess myself.
The U and the V.
I usually never write a stick on the U, so I'm going to start doing that.
Put a stick up. You mean like the. Okay.